And now if you're questioning mental health during this very unique time, you are not alone. Mel caught up with a professional who has some coping skills, especially for women.
It seems that COVID-19, the stress that comes with it, is affecting men and women differently.
We're definitely seeing women say that their mental health concerns are at a higher percentage than men. They feel like they're carrying a bigger burden maybe than men are.
Do men express themselves differently, and so we don't think that men are suffering as much as we are as women?
There was a response on the survey, so the questions were the same for men and women. I think part of our DNA as women, we have a tendency to be nurturing, wanting to make sure everybody's okay. If we have kids at home, we feel the need to make sure that they're handling this okay.
You kind of feel like you're holding your breath and hanging out for when it gets back to the new normal. What's the best way to, I guess, manage getting through right now?
Well, number one is just not expecting ourselves to be perfect, and it's okay when on days when we might not be okay. I think sometimes we're so hard on ourselves that creates an added level of pressure. So like embracing that I'm feeling this way, and then maybe trying to break that moment by connecting with a trusted friend or having a conversation with somebody who usually brings laughter to your life, or maybe going to do a fun activity with the kids just to break that moment of stress or anxiety or whatever you're feeling. If you set like little goals of what you want to accomplish that day, and then having a fun time celebrating that can help really keep you focused on what is working and what is going well, instead of all the unknowns and the anxiety about worrying about the future. So it's just a day-to-day thing. I think we just need to be kind to ourselves and not expect perfection. No one's been through this before. We're probably gonna make some mistakes along the way. Celebrating what did go well that day, or what good vision we saw of a neighbor helping somebody, that you could kind of break that cycle of negative thought. We have great resources. If you go to phoenix.edu, we have a very specific page to just the COVID environment. And so there's webinars there, free webinars on how to manage stress, on how to talk to your kids about what's happening. So there's a lot of great resources on the phoenix.edu page.